And welcome everybody here in Twitch chat and everybody on YouTube who's watching this video later on for some Grixis Midrange. We're changing up this deck just a tiny bit. As we've talked about the last couple of times that we've been playing it, haven't really liked the Dreadhorde Butcher, and so we're moving away from Dreadhorde Butcher and just to a little bit more interaction and everything. Basically, we got this Tombbound Lich in here now. This is just a card that can help smooth out our draws and everything and be a good blocker that has Death Touch and, you know, force them to block as well. Otherwise, we get more triggers. I'm putting a Noxious Grasp in the main because it's just really a good card. It's good against like every deck, basically. So those are like a couple things that we changed that I'm changing this time. Last time we put in the Bedecks, and the Bedecks felt really good, honestly, with, you know, being a solid removal spell for a Danto Vanguard or, you know, anything early, and then also later on in the game, dealing damage to a player, a planeswalker, or an opponent, and destroying a land. It just felt like a pretty good versatile spell. Still trying out Thief of Sanity. I really considered, instead of playing the 3 Thief and the 1 Tombbound Lich, just putting in 4 War Bosses. Really, really considered that. I think I still want Thief of Sanity, though. But if the Thieves are not good, could definitely see moving towards War Boss instead. But yeah, this is just a pretty fun deck to play. I like this as Grixis right now. We still have a lot of good Grixis interaction. We got Nicol Bolas Dragon God, which is an incredible card. Same with Nicol Bolas the Ravager. We have both of our Boluses, which are incredible cards. But then we're filling out the deck with some other threats as well, with like Knight of the Ebon Legion, you know, Chandra Angrath, Rekindling Phoenix. Just a lot of just good cards in this deck. It's a fun deck to play. And so we're playing it here. Let's play some Grixis Midrange. So we're going to play over in Ranked. I haven't played Ranked in a while. So our last two decks, we're going to play Ranked matches. Not sure exactly how many we'll play. Probably 5 matches, but, you know, we'll keep a look at the time if the matches take a while. No, I didn't really like it with Dreadhorde Butcher. I played it a lot with Dreadhorde Butcher and everything, and it was just... the card was frequently underwhelming and not impactful enough, and I was sideboarding it out all the time and just eventually just got rid of it, basically. There are definitely times where it's really good. Picking off a planeswalker like a Teferi that just minused, you know, can be really nice. There are certainly situations where Dreadhorde Butcher is very good. Yeah, that deck looks pretty good, Ripper. You could probably use just a little bit more removal. Another removal spell or two. Like Warrant Warden is one to kind of look at there for your Bant Flash deck. Like 3 Hero of Dominaria maybe is a little much, or 6 counter, 6 like the 4 absorbs, basically, like that's like a whole lot of absorbs. Like maybe an absorb or 2 could be removal instead. Alright, anyway, back to over to our game. Good looking hand here. We got 2 black sources towards Dragon God. We need one more. I like drawing the land, but kind of need another black source. But it's not a shock land, so that's good. That was a good light up the stage. Very good light at the stage. I haven't gotten to like attack, like turn Bedeck into a pump spell, you know, like making this like a 7/1 creature to attack them for 7 for lethal or something. I haven't been able to do that yet. Or, you know, like activate Knight and then, you know, give it an extra 3 with Bedeck or something. Haven't done that one yet. Yeah, this is like a perfect metagame for a Bedeck. There's 3 Bedevils in this deck. I don't like Carnival Carnage as much. Like, the 1 damage doesn't kill enough creatures. There are certainly some creatures that it kills, but doesn't kill enough. Not in love with that card with other options. It's awesome. You'll get him, buddies. Wonder if they're blocking. I assume if they would have had a shock to kill the knight, they would have just shocked it and attacked with the firebrand also. Another blue red land.
I don't have enough swears right now.
That thing could just do too much stuff. It's just worth, you know, spending 3 mana to get rid of it and basically casting a free Bedevil. Because they could have, you know, like Lightning Strike and then buy back Lightning Strike. And it could just be a big mess, you know, like, even though it would have been nice to play Ravager. I don't think we can really win this. Frenzy is really tough to beat. Yep, Frenzy is Grixis' nightmare, that's for sure.
that suits me well. My schemes have been foiled. I outsmarted you eons ago.
Can't really, I'm just, dead to everything, so.
You have tasted but a drop of power.
That's lethal. Welcome back, 619. Yeah, frenzy is our bane, that's for sure. I could try to duress away frenzy. I don't want to unmoored ego frenzy. I can't really take turn three off against red. I don't know if the whole try to duress away frenzy really works though. I actually don't really mind Thief of Sanity, even though, especially on the play, even though it dies very easily, because the games that, if it doesn't die, we have, a whole lot of interaction and everything, and get to land a thief later. The games that doesn't die can really take over. Just basically what I feel like, Seraph. Just if I feel like playing ranked or not playing ranked. Usually in general, as a generalized thing, decks that I think are stronger are the decks I'm playing in ranked are decks that I believe are stronger than normal. If there's a deck that's real janky, I'll just be playing that in the league kind of thing. So basically, if I'm playing a deck in ranked, then I think it's pretty good. Not necessarily the best deck ever, but pretty good. I am not shocking to play duress, because then it's, it's what's the point of taking a 3 damage burn spell if you're going to take 2 damage to do it and a card. Not. Teamer land destruction was fun. Yeah, enjoyed that one. Alright, so a couple firebrands. Don't hit super hard, but they hit hard enough. Another 5 drop. Not ideal of a draw step. Alright, so plan here is just bedevil the Chain Whirler this turn. He uses my mana the best. Give them another draw step of maybe finding Frenzy. Like they could have just drawn Frenzy there. Weird. I guess they're scared of Ritual of Soot. Or they just played around the duress in hand perfectly. Yeah, that's an option with Grixis. Yeah, four Bloods on four Lotus Field, and then really big mana stuff. That option is worse when you don't have your Blood Sun to go with your Lotus Field to ramp and everything like that, and it's a slower option, but obviously it's going to be very good against... against Field of the Dead immediately.
You're just fuel for the fires.
But I'd be worried about that kind of deck against like Vampires, for example. Or obviously Mono Red too. Mono Red's tough to beat with the Grixis anyway, though. All right, time to start destroying these lands.
My revenge will be pain. Let your weak minds crumble.
Trying to stabilize at five.
No fire, no steel.
Sure, I guess.
I will return one day. You have no weakness I cannot exploit. I am a god once again. No!
Gets rid of an extra land there.
No fire, no steel.
All right, get rid of more lands.
I will wipe your bloodline. My intellect is without limit. No fire, no steel.
We're getting there. Not... I'm feeling good about this one, but not feeling so good about... Okay, never mind. That's what they need to do, is draw a burn spell. And so that's one burn spell. There's nothing I can draw.
No fire, no steel.
There's nothing I can draw that stops my opponent from drawing a three damage burn spell. If they do that, I lose.
I thought I was fighting dragons when I was truly fighting ants.
But if they don't, I win. Well, I mean, I guess if they just draw any a one damage burn spell thing. That can only destroy non-basic lands? That's lame. We got our blocker still with Chain Whirler. This thing's at... Dragon God's at 8 loyalty. So it can ultimate. So that's why I wanted to flip. I assume my opponent is going to kill me now with the oops thing. Yeah, I assume they drew lethal. So I think this build of Grixis that we have here looks to be pretty bad against mono red. Looks like I have not respected the mono red matchup nearly as enough as we should with this. You know, like without having like Enter the God Eternals or Moment of Craving or anything like that. Yeah, our mono red matchup looks really bad. That went pretty well for us. And, you know, we were still at such a low life total and we were on the play. Yeah, if we're on the draw, that would have been really bad. Yeah, Matchmaker does know each deck's weakness. So yeah, I could have gone the destroy two lands route, but being at three, all I need to draw is a lightning strike to kill me. And we wouldn't have had lethal the next turn. But, you know, with them drawing skewer, yeah, if I would have gone destroy two lands, you know, in hindsight, that would have probably gotten me there, because then skewer didn't do anything with them drawing a three mana spell there. And then we could, you know, destroy a land the next turn and everything. I went for the, you know, give them one turn to draw the three damage burn spell. If not, we win with the Nicol Bolas ultimate. And it didn't work out. I don't really know of a good Dragons deck. This could have gone better for us. Oh, there we go. My opponent's probably just like one land away from playing Teferi and then we lose kind of thing. But now, that's what I was thinking, but now we're one land away from Dragon God. It needs to be a black source. Because we got double blue red land. Black source. Okay. We're in there.
Multiverse.
Is it Othakaya? No, they're getting ready to cast down. That's fine. Mote of my power. I'm happy with them not having cast down.
Right on schedule. Time is much more malleable than people think.
This, of course, is the time that
once I am one again.
Dreadhorde Butcher is at its best, you know, right after a Planeswalker minuses. Like, if this, like, Phoenix was a Dreadhorde Butcher, that would have been nice.
If you wish to see, meditate and prepare.
Well, I don't get to draw a card. I'm still ticking up. Like, there's not a reason not to tick up. They still have to exile something.
Conceivable! Martyred you eons ago.
Doubt it.
cannot see your folly.
All right, let's get rid of one of those blue sources and not let them minus Narset again.
I have other plans.
Sure.
All will bow before Nicole Bold for defiances and fury. You have no weakness that I cannot exploit.
Cool. Thanks for getting rid of Disfigure. I appreciate that. Yeah, just kind of a little bit of everything with this ult time midrange earlier.
Another time.
Ugh, that's really bad.
Keep an open mind.
Hmm.
Violence is upsetting.
I don't know if I'm supposed to be keeping this Thief of Sanity. Thief doesn't really pair against Teferi too well, especially a Teferi that has a machine gun attached.
This isn't a fight you can win. Here we go.
Oh, that's lucky. I was pretty lucky getting a removal spell there for the night.
I've got time. Trust me, you'll thank me later. Trust me, I have a plan.
Man. This turn's been really bad for me. And then big Teferi.
You show remorse. I'll show
really as bad as they could go.
Keep up the pace. Let's try this.
I just got nothing over here.
This is hardly my worst defeat.
Bleh.
Let's skip to the good part.
Bank.
Hopefully we have like four more lands on top. Land, land. Okay, two lands of Thought Erasure. But the Ravager is really good.
I won't let you win.
Land again. Bleh.
No time for a break.
Yeah, Teferi with Othakaya is quite strong. That main deck Elder spell got me pretty good too, though. What are these? There they are. All right, so we get rid of the cast downs, the Legion's Ends. The Hostage Takers, Phoenix, not good against Teferi, but good against basically everything else that's not Teferi. Hey, Undead Voodoo, welcome to the channel. Thank you so much, 619. Santa 619. Oops. Sub number 12 on the day. Oh, this card. Get rid of that card. Okay, there we go. That's better. Get that card back. There we go. Hey, Deco Knight. Thanks for resubbing there for 32 months? I've been streaming that long? Dang, I've been here since the beginning. Thank you so much, Deco Knight. Chandra Thought Erasure is a good combination, of course, unless they have 3 mana Teferi in play, because you do cast stuff at instant speed, technically, with the Chandra, so you don't get to... use that. Storm getting the sub from 619. Thank you so much. And Havukas. Oh, well, you're welcome. Thank you for that subscription there. All right, so we'll take the Thought Erasure. And I do need a fifth land, so we'll just keep this. Gonna need that fifth land there.
Won't lie, I'm a pretty great pyromancer. Fire spreads fast. With help.
So we'll see if they Othakaya the Chandra. If so, we get to play Tombbound Lich. Yeah, they did not. I'll still play it. It's... I would like to, like... Honestly, I would like to... -3... Or -2 and... get rid of the Othakaya that way. But it's a little risky doing that. I think it's gonna be a long, long time.
The immortal Nicole Bolas will be your end. I have other plans. Let your weak minds crumble.
These little guys are great!
So, of course, if they have... if they have Elder Spell, it's a huge problem. If they don't have Elder Spell, I like where we're at.
This isn't a fight you can win. Hold that thought.
No Elder Spell, that's good. Be a long, long time.
That didn't go according to plan.
My revenge will be painful. My intellect is without limit.
Study? Focus? I just want to burn stuff already.
If they don't have an answer for Nicol Bolas, we get to win the game next turn.
Excellent timing. That's more like it.
I train and own your prowess.
All right, we don't get to win the game.
Stay back. I'm an explosively good pyromancer. Glad I can help with your not being on fire problem. Hey, these little guys are great.
I suppose that's how it was meant.
I have reached my limit.
I will wipe your bloodline, my
son. We played against Mono Red in the previous match. Mono Red's really hard to beat.
Here. What a good, mindless minion.
All right, we recast Bedevil. Kill Liliana. And now... they don't have anything for... They don't have any... Planeswalker is out, so we get to minus 8. Okay, can we get game 3? Yeah, Grixis is really cool. It's so close to being good too. It's just not quite there. But you have like games like that that are just like, you know, that are really sweet and everything. But then, you know, there's just not all the games, you know. But yeah, there's definitely holes with Grixis. It's close. Oh yeah, I definitely, yeah, that's, I agree there. I want Selesnya to be stronger also. Selesnya, like, green and white is just so weak right now. They just don't have good answers to the best stuff in the format. You know, like, not having any good answers basically at all to Scapeshift, Field of the Dead is just kind of makes it really hard to play green and white. We need spells. We really need spells. This is unreal. Four draw steps, four lands. Darn, they found blue mana. And they put other blue mana over in the graveyard. So if they're not playing anything here, it's like, what do they have in hand? I feel like it's a Dovin's Veto. Like, if they have, like, nothing to play here, like, they probably have the counterspell, like we've seen Dovin's Veto from them. That would make a lot of sense.
Just the trick for this.
Hmm. Man, I really like Angrath. But we really should just duress, though. So they could also have Planeswalker removal like Elderspell. Which, yep, looks like they have that. But that's fine. Like, all that did was just kill my Nicol Bolas, like, one for one. And we got we gained the duress. We have another Nicol Bolas also. Ah, no. No veto. Well then.
I will spare you in exchange for no witness a mote of my power. I will return.
Why aren't they just getting rid of lands?
You have no weakness I cannot exploit.
I know this is way too much. They could just draw Kaya's Wrath and I'll feel silly. But we're still doing just fine. So that was one that kind of shows the good part about playing Grixis midrange compared to Grixis control. If you're playing Grixis control, they just easily board out like the cast downs and disfigures and stuff like that. And so, like, you know, they drew those cast downs and disfigures before we had the creatures to actually kill them. And, you know, we got to deal with those. And, like, they were just, you know, like, they were just sitting there with the cast down in their hand instead of something that could have been more impactful for that whole game. I'm not worried about being mythic or not being mythic. I have been mythic every single month. This is like the first month that I'm not mythic this late into the month. So we'll see. All that really matters to me is to get in the top 1,000 in like one of the next couple months. To be qualified for the next MCQ on Arena. That's easy enough to do. Whether I do that this month or next month. We'll see. All right, well, Thief is hitting him. So, like, four color Yurok Elemental Field of the Dead? I don't know. Five color. Oh, it's gotta be Golos. Yeah, this is probably Nexus Golos. Golos Nexus stuff. They're playing five color, it's gotta be Golos. Oh, now it's top 1,200 instead of top 1,000? Okay, cool. So yeah, no, I'm not really fussed about rank. The pirate does the yoinking. Pirate yoink. We are looking for their nexuses. That would be nice. We are thinning their deck, though, also, for them to find their own nexus. All right, one Golos down. Alright, it discarded Nexus. I guess maybe I should have cast that Ravager first before hitting him with Thief. But presumably they have another Nexus or two in hand. Nexi. Can we do 15 damage? No, definitely can't now. This could be really bad. I'm just going to be spending my mana the next few turns. Ooh, okay. Okay, well, we get to do this instead of playing Dragon God to kill Krasis. But this could still be really bad, though, of course. I have two Nexus. It's gonna be tough to beat two Nexus, to be honest. So I can go double ramp, get the two swamps out of my deck. You know, get the two Risen Reef triggers. Or Krasis as a 3-3. That's my best way of staying alive, I suppose. Getting a 3-3 to block. I don't think we win this, honestly. I think this is over. Probably, because they have all four Nexus still, and they only have 20 cards left, and they get to activate this Golos. They did a good job of just, like, ramping and setting this up. They did a really good job of not exposing Golos or anything. Yeah, I don't think... I think this is over. They have... Should have just all four Nexuses left. They shouldn't really have played that land, because if their Golos hits land, they could play that. Oh, they're just playing that. Okay, well, that's... It's definitely over now. Alright, on Mordigo, Blood Suns. Chandra can recast on Mordigo or recast discard spells. Go up to four Legion's End. I don't know, maybe Chandra. Let's see. So Knight's pretty slow. So is Lich. So is Phoenix. So this is 64. And just one Chandra. Basically, Hostage Taker and Angrath are quite good against Krasis. But not so great against non-Krasis. This Bedazzle is pretty slow. Maybe it's just take out Bedazzle. That does kill. This does kill Risen Reef, though. Killing Risen Reef is kind of important. All right, we'll play one. All right, need to draw lands. Do I want to take Nexus or Hydroid Krasis? It's Nexus. Sir Yulin Drake? So it's all four copies of Golos. I was thinking maybe three, but it's all four. So yeah, it is just Golos, Krasis, and Field of the Dead. And there's like no removal in here, no interaction. I should have just named Krasis. What? I guess as I was clicking on the... I guess I ran out of time. Yeah, I ran out... I guess I didn't click them fast enough. But it just took... I clicked the other ones. I clicked the two in the library, and I guess as I was clicking the two in hand, it ran out of time, and it just said you don't get any, I guess. Yeah, you have to click done. I guess I ran out of time. All right, well, lesson learned. I've never done that before. I've never seen that happen before, so lesson learned. And not take quite as long looking at the deck. I went like that second double check of making sure they didn't really have any other interaction, and I should not have done that double check there. So yeah, that's really unfortunate. But lesson learned, you know, like if you're watching this at home, make sure you click on all of them a little bit faster than what I just did. I wish I would have killed the Sir Yulindrake before. Because Sir Yulindrake just counters the Thought Erasure. Kind of wish I would have killed that before. But well, that's out of there. If we get one more mana, we can like we can Chandra the recast the Unmoored Ego. Hope they drew a bunch of Crasises. Yay.
Control. Just let me burn. Fire spreads fast with help.
All right, not attacking because otherwise they could just like, you know, attack Chandra for one Nexus, attack Chandra for one Nexus, and so on. This is not a draw two. Oh, right, we have Risen Reef. I forgot about us having Risen Reef chilling over here. I was like, the Chandra Zero is in a draw too. But I wanted to put a counter on it, so I got to minus and then minus again. You know, like I wanted to be able to minus twice in a row. But yeah, I guess I could have just drawn two.
Chandra, remember that spell.
All right, those are actually out of here this time. Just had to wait a little bit to get him. But we got him. Their deck kind of doesn't do anything anymore. Between Nexus being gone, Bloodsun being out here. These cards kind of just don't do anything.
Don't worry, I brought company. I know who I am, and no one is telling me what to do. No pressure.
All right, get that clock going. They have this Drake. They have 4 Krasis, 4 Golos, and that Drake. So how many Krasis is in? So 2 Krasis are gone. So there's another Golos. Get Krasis. Yeah. So yeah, they don't really have worthwhile cards left in their deck. Be careful. Be careful that your two Chandras don't talk to each other. They will cause a time paradox. That's pretty good.
Keep it up and you'll pay.
All right. All right, Hostage Taker looked really good, especially if they don't have removal. Kind of assuming they're going to board in like some kind of removal or Veil of Summers or something. Are they not even playing like Veil of Summer? Like counters at all? Makes my life a lot easier if they're not. Game number 3. Duress is good against their interaction if they have it. I like having the Duresses in here, and it's still just getting Growth Spiral, Circuitous Route, that kind of stuff. That's pretty important. I'm not expecting their deck to look exactly the same here. I would really like to draw Blood Sun. That was a big part of us just being really safe, was having the Blood Sun last game. So Rejuvenator, of course, does a better job of finding Field of the Dead, but even like right now, like with Field of the Dead, they're not. That was a great card. I was gonna say they're not that close to activating it. That was probably the perfect draw step for them, honestly. That sped them up so much. That was not a good land play. Unless they drew Krasis. Oh, wow. Oh, we ripped a perfect card. How about that? Another Krasis? Darn. They rip 2 perfect cards, we get a perfect card. So we want to be seeing their Nexuses with the Thief of Sanity and Field of the Deads, of course. Get those out of there. Agent of Treachery. It's a good card. Go ahead and ramp into Nexus here. Two can play that game. Sorry, Jack Nelly. I guess I'm supposed to play it before hitting them, so I have a better chance of seeing it. Again. Give me that. Agent of Treachery trigger. Good old Thief of Sanity. That was pretty sweet. That was a sweet game there. Yeah. Yeah, that was a fun game right there. Yeah, those are some long games. For sure there. I think I may stop the Grixis Midrange here. Played some good long games of Magic. And get to Sultai Treachery is not going to be a slow deck either, or it's not going to be a fast deck either. So I want to have plenty of time to play some Sultai Treachery games because that's a new deck. So yeah, Thief of Sanity felt awesome. That card was great. So yeah, we lost. So what we learned here, so we learned we're not good at all against mono red. Definitely learned that, but I really don't mind my Esper matchup, which last format, I could not say that I liked my Esper matchup at all. Our Esper opponent didn't draw very well in the game we played against them, but having cards like Knight of the Ebon Legion, Thief of Sanity in our deck, they know about, you know, like they had like their cast downs and disfigure, in post board, but then we just had like this kind of stuff and punished them for having like those dead cards in their deck post board, kind of like the whole Esper hero type thing, which is really nice. But yeah, mono red's just gonna be really tough, but I do like our Scape Shift kind of matchup, or just our Field of the Dead matchups with having Blood Suns and Unmoored Egos and a whole lot of hand disruption with Thought Erasures and Duress, and then yeah, having Thief of Sanity is nice. This Chandra was quite good for us in the sideboard. Got to recast Unmoored Ego, got to recast like Thought Erasure and Bedevil and stuff like that also. Yeah. So this deck felt pretty good. Felt pretty good still. Did not really get to do anything with the Tombbound Lynch. Only had it one game against Esper. It got Oath of Kaiad. it did loot away an extra land before getting Othakayad, you know, so it did get a little bit of value before getting Othakayad. But that was the only time we saw it. Maybe the Angrath's a little bit much. I just like Angrath so much. But maybe it should just be another Awakened Inferno. Or, you know, something else cheaper. Didn't get to do a whole lot with Bedeck. Absolutely losing M19 Bolas will hurt Grixis, and losing all of the check lands really hurts Grixis. That's the check lands are pretty important in this deck, especially trying to cast this triple black Nicol Bolas. You don't really want like Temple of Epiphany. So we'll have to see what the dual lands are in the next set. You know, assuming that the dual lands are going to be the five sets of colors that were not in M19 that the temples are not. So like we should have a blue black dual land and a red black dual land in Throne of Eldraine. So depending on what those are, it could really help out Nicol Bolas Dragon God if they're like, you know, if they are good and like pretty easy to make triple black kind of thing, or if they're not very good, it could hurt. You know, we'll have to see what they are. So basically that's something to like, it could be that Grixis is the type of, you know, three color combination that you want to stay away from if those Throne of Eldraine lands aren't very good, and you want to be more like teamer that has Temple of Epiphany and Temple of Mystery, and you want to be like something that has two temples. Or it could be that Grixis is a good color pairing that, you know, you want two of the Throne of Eldraine lands. You know, we'll just kind of have to see there. There we go. So that's Grixis Midrange. So if you're watching the video later on YouTube, hope you enjoyed the deck. Don't forget to hit that like and subscribe buttons over there. Sorry, we just played the three matches here. I've had some longer leagues, and the Sultai Treachery should be a longer one as well in a little bit. But we still had three good leagues there. Like, those are three good matches. You know, like, we played against Mono Red and then Esper Control and then Teamer Golo. So we got to play, like, the full spectrum. So that's good. So, all right. Thank you so much for watching Grixis Midrange here. Again, don't forget to the like, subscribe buttons over there. Leave comments, all that kind of stuff. But there we go. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you for the next video.